Hi, I'm Frane Lessac. I'm a children's book illustrator, and I'm going to show you how I create my picture books. I love making books for children. Well, first of all, the medium I love to use the most is gouache paints. They like a very heavy watercolor. I like them because if I make a mistake, I can paint over and fix it. They're easy to mix, and I paint in layers. So whatever color I put down, I can paint on top, and you won't see what's underneath. To mix my paints, I use these little trays. And every book has three or four different trays going on at the same time for the colors of that book. If I'm doing a book on the Caribbean, they'd be very bright palettes. Right now, what I'm working on is a book set in the Erie Canal in 1835, and my palette is a very North American farmyard scenes. When I'm doing oil paints, which I do if I ever have exhibitions, I have a very different palette. This is my paintings that I create from oils here. This palette is every single painting I've ever created has been on this palette. This palette must be over 40 years old. So what I have to do when I create a book is I have to do some sketches first to show the publisher what I'm going to have in my book. And the best way to do that is just getting the size of the book and then in pencil, draw it out, leaving a space where the words are going to go. Make sure I never put anything important in the gutter of the book. Once I have that, then I paint away. I use lots of different size brushes when I create my art. I start with a big flat brush like that and I paint my entire background first, working down using smaller brushes till I get to even my baby brushes, where there's only a few hairs on this. But with little brushes, I could do little detail, tiny little things like eyebrows or eyelashes and all those little things. Sometimes to get extreme close-ups, I use a magnifier light. One of the best things about being a children's author and illustrator is to be able to go and travel and work and meet children from around the world. Living here in Australia, we get to travel out a lot to Central Australia, to remote communities where we get children's books in children's hands, and we actually have the children make their own books. Some of the most amazing experiences in my life have happened out there where the children will be sleeping out around a campfire at night, and then they come to school in the morning with twigs in their hair and bare feet. They have breakfast at the school, and then they're on the internet, and they have the latest technology. The artistic levels out there are outstanding. The kids love picture books, and to make their own books always is very precious to them. I never thought one day I'd be making children's books. I thought I was going to be a veterinarian. I had many pets. I had a pet monkey. I had lots of pet snakes. So it's a big surprise today that I've created these books. This is my first one I wanted to share with you. It's called My Little Island. It was based on a little island where I lived in the Caribbean that I loved so much that I thought I'd make a book for children about it. And I have all the beautiful trees and flowers that grew there. The island had funny animals there called mountain chickens, and they used to bark like a dog. So I painted the mountain chicken frogs in there. This is one of my latest books, The Greatest Liar on Earth, A True Story. This book's just about to come out in America, and it's out in Australia here, about Louis de Rougemont. So I love creating these books, mostly books about different places around the world, many places I've traveled to myself, and if I can't travel there, I go to the library and I talk to people to do my research.